In this video, we're going to talk about GDI fuel injectors and how to do a balance test using a scan tool. As we know, GDI systems are quite a bit different. It's uncommon that I'm going to undo a fuel line on one of these and, you know, put in a fuel pressure gauge in series like we do on port fuel vehicles. The high pressure really inhibits that process. And so there's some other options, right? There's specialty equipment. There's a Kent Moore active fuel injector test kit, which is much like an OTC kit that we did in another video for port fuel. And that kit is designed to work with GDI vehicles to control the injector, to monitor the high pressure, and it has the ability to do that. That kit's quite expensive and it is extra setup. And so in this video, we're looking at how do I use a scan tool to learn similar information. And so we're gonna use the Buick behind me here and go through what General Motors offers us as an automated injector balance test or fuel injector balance test, right? Depending on the tool that we use. So we'll go through that sequence, look at that test, look at the service info about how to interpret results. And we're also gonna do it on multiple scan tools. So I've got the GDS2 and MDI2 here. We're gonna do that with the factory tool first, but say you don't have a factory tool, we're gonna go through and look at, is that test available? And what does it look like for a Snap-on platform and an OTC platform? So for this test, we're gonna use a few different scan tools just to prove out that they all do the same function. So this first one, I'm gonna use the GDS2 through the MDI. And so we're connected to the car. This is our 2015 Buick Regal. It's got a 2-liter with GDI and turbocharger. I'm gonna go into my module. And so now we're gonna look at control functions. Look at my fuel system, and then right there I've got fuel injector balance. I'm gonna answer some questions about options there. So I've got the vehicle in park. We're all set. So now what happens is I've got all four of my injectors listed here and at the bottom, and one by one I'm going to command them. We can hear the RPM for the vehicle drop as that injector is disabled and then it returns. And so what happens in the meantime is that this number for our pressure, in this case it's KPA, is recorded for what the drop was. And really what's happening here is that the PCM is disabling this injector and we're looking for what is the climb in pressure. So we completed the test. Let's talk about the numbers and the procedure for this. So I've got all four of my injectors. I've got a drop in KPA, right? The result of that injector being disabled and coming back. And then if we look over to the side here, so General Motors specifies two different ways that you could do a balance test for these fuel injectors. One of them is to use a test kit, which is a Kent Moore active injector test kit. It's an expensive kit. I believe the price is about $3,000, and it allows you to do similar things to the OTC box that we did with the port fuel. But if we don't have that kit, but we have a scan tool, right, here are the directions for what we just went through. So they want you to verify that the low pressure side is okay. So we've got to do some of our traditional diagnostics there. Get the engine idling, make sure that you've got good high pressure fuel to work with, right? So we need to do some audits about the high pressure pump and lower pressure pump before we get to this injector balance test. And then we get to it through the scan tool, just like we did, go through and record each one. And then there's the analysis when you look at, you know, 6, 7, and 8 on this. So if this car had a misfire, we had a suspected bad fuel injector, I'm going to drop that number. I'm going to add and average the other 3, and then I'm gonna multiply that average by 0.2, right? And that's gonna give me this 20% variance, right? And basically anything outside of a 20% variance, they say is an issue, and that injector should be replaced. So that's a great test on the factory tool, but what if you don't have the factory tool? So let's see how the aftermarket tools compare and how they operate with this test. So Solas Edge connected with my 2015 Regal. I'm gonna go to functional tests. Right there, I've got automated injector balance. Make sure my AC is off, I'm in idle and park. This tells me what's gonna happen. It's gonna pulse each injector in a consecutive order, look for a dip, record those results, and they're displayed at the end of the test. So I'm gonna hit continue. So we can hear and see some changes. Engine speed dips every time that we go through a specific cylinder test. And so now it says that I've got all four cylinders completed, and I go down, and here are my values for each cylinder. So cylinder 1, 2, 3, and 4, and in this case, they're giving this data to me in PSI instead of KPA, like on the GDS tool. So I could do the same analysis, take these, get rid of my suspected cylinder, create an average, and determine if I have a problem. One more tool, next up, OTC Encore. I'm gonna go ahead and auto ID. Select my vehicle. There we go, we've got a Regal. All right, so I met with my main menu. I'm gonna go to special tests. We're interested in engine. This is not all-wheel drive. So then over here, I'm gonna scroll down. We've got some categories. We'll go to fuel system, fuel injector balance. It wants me to start the engine. We've got it idling right now. It wants me to select injector. Okay, so I did injector 1, I hit select injector, do injector 2. I can hear the RPM reducing as it takes that injector away. Injector 3. And injector 4. Right, and so now I've got all my numbers. We can assume based on those numbers, those are in KPA. So very similar. The terminology and the display is more similar on this tool to the GDS than the Snap-on one was. So that's the General Motors automated injector or fuel injector balance test for a GDI system. That procedure and sequence that we're looking at is fuel system diagnosis. That pinpoint test or trouble tree can be found in a variety of different codes, right? Any of the misfire codes that comes up. I'd looked at a P0302 to define that sequence. So it is something that we're gonna encounter. As we know, GDI vehicles are incredibly common, and so our diagnostic strategy has to change a little bit from port fuel to work with these systems. I hope too it was helpful to see the different scan tools, right, and see that that test is available pretty broadly. We don't have to have the factory tool to do it. The other specialty box, that Kent Moore tool, the active injector test box, is another option, right, if your dealership, your shop has that tool, right? But most of us technicians, we want to do something quick and easy to get as much information as we can before we think or decide that we need to go deeper. And so that's where the scan tool test is really great. And again, with GDI diagnostics, there's a lot that we can learn from a scan tool, right? We can look at the rail pressure, look at that high pressure output from the pump. In some vehicles, we can look at low pressure. Some vehicles will have another sensor on the low pressure side. And so we can do a lot with that. We can learn quite a bit before we go into other test equipment or, you know, using a picoscope.